I'm going to briefly describe the idea behind reverse osmosis, which is used on a fairly large scale for water purification. And the idea is, so first thought, in order to understand it, let's look at osmosis. And so suppose I'm looking at the cross section of a container, and this is a membrane that divides two halves of the container. And this membrane will allow water to permeate, but will not allow salt. So let's start out. Suppose we put water on both sides at equilibrium. The heights of the water will be the same. Chemical potentials of water are the same on both sides of the membrane. Now what I'm going to do is add salt to the right side and then let it go to equilibrium again. So what is it going to look like when we're again at equilibrium? Well, the water on the left side is now going to permeate through the membrane to the right side until the chemical potentials are again equal. So the water level here will go down, and the water level here, remember this is water plus salt, this level will go up until this pressure difference. This is a pressure difference due to the fact the heights of the liquid are not the same. So the density of the water times the height times the gravitational constant. That pressure is the osmotic pressure, sometimes represented by pi. And so now we're again at equilibrium. There's no water permeation through the membrane. So let's now start with this condition. So starting with the same condition, and suppose now I exert pressure and push down on the right side. What that's going to do is cause water to flow this way. And now, again, let's look at equilibrium. The water level on the left is going to rise. Of course, the water level on the right is going to decrease. This is water plus salt on the right side. Again, this is at equilibrium. There's no longer flow, and that's because the chemical potential of water on the left side is equal to the chemical potential of water on the right side. So this is referred to then as reverse osmosis, where we've forced water through the membrane by exerting pressure. So the idea would be if we started here with salt water, we could make more pure water, because we have a membrane that will not allow the salt to permeate. Well, let's look at a diagram then that represents this behavior. So, if we're not at equilibrium, then we'll have flow through the membrane continuously. And here's the idea that we feed into our system salt water, so we're continuously feeding, so we don't allow the system to get to equilibrium. You'll notice that the salt concentration leaving is higher than that entering because we're getting pure water here in the outlet. And how much water we get out is a function of this pressure difference, the feed pressure, 41 atmospheres, and the outlet pressure, permeate pressure, is 1 atmosphere. So the figure then on the right shows the water flux as a function of pressure drop across the membrane. So what I've indicated here is that osmotic pressure that I just mentioned previously. If we're below the osmotic pressure, then this is osmosis, meaning water is going to go from the pure water side to the salt water, trying to make chemical potentials equal. If we're above the osmotic pressure, as I've shown a diagram on the left, then we'll get water flowing to the pure water side, and we'll be concentrating the salt, so this retentate leaving has a higher salt concentration. And what this green line looks like is a function of how well we stir this system, because of the fact there's concentration polarization near the membrane surface. And so what that means, if we look at this membrane surface, And we have on this side water, and here on this side water plus salt, just like in the figure immediately above this. Then very near the surface, the salt concentration will be higher than out here in the bulk, right? So out here we have, for example, 0.0445 is the mole fraction, but right near the surface it'll be higher, which means the concentration of water will be lower than the bulk, and that means the driving force for water to permeate will be lower than it would be without concentration polarization. And that's due to the fact we have a boundary layer near the surface, and so we're relying on diffusion for water to move through that boundary layer. And of course the salt has to move away from the membrane surface. And that boundary layer can be decreased if we have better mixing. So this is one of the reasons we show that we're stirring this, trying to mix and decrease that boundary layer, and therefore this green line will look different. It'll be up higher if I have a higher rate of mixing. So it's just a brief idea of what reverse osmosis is. Again, the point is it's used very large scale to purify water, and it's relying on chemical potential differences as driving forces for water to permeate through a membrane.